弟兄姐妹们大家好啊，欢迎大家来到我们虹桥基督教英语专场这个礼拜周日聚会啊，我是 Norman 啊，在此欢迎大家来到我们当中。此刻我们还是持续我们的线上聚会，若有进一步的复会消息，我们将会为大家带来更新的信息，因此非常感谢你们的耐心等候以及代祷。稍后我们的敬拜赞美团将带领我们预备好我们的心来到上帝面前，何牧师也将为我们带来另一个从主而来的主日信息。但在此之前，我们有一些简要的通告要告知大家。那么首先 ICS 是多教派在一起聚会的基督教教会，为遵守地方政府的相关规定， ICS 线上聚会以及活动只针对外国护照持有者开放。如果你是刚到上海你或者你是第一次参加我们的线上聚会，或者你已经是我们教会成员之一但想要更深入参与我们的话，欢迎参加我们的细胞小组我们在上海呢有超过20个细胞小组，每周都会一同相聚。若你有兴趣想了解更多关于细胞小组的背景并与他们连结的话，敬请透过屏幕上显示的二维码报名，我们教会同工会为你跟进介绍和做连结另外我们的青少年团契持续每周日早上10点在 Zoom 会议线上聚会，直到复会为止。青少年们如果有兴趣成为 Anchor 的一份子，或者想要更多的连接或参与请发送邮件到屏幕上显示的邮箱。那么请注意 ICS 每日灵修也可以通过 ICS 网站的这个链接进入，或者你可以扫描屏幕上的 QR 码。那么作为教会以及 TEC 就是外籍人士中心的大使中心之一，我们一向积极支持 TEC 每年对外籍社群所组织的活动的以下呢有一些 TEC 的通告首先是关于河南省这个防汛救灾的事宜为了支持受严重洪涝影响的河南恢复重建，上海市慈善基金会联合澎湃新闻共同发起防汛救灾驰援河南专项行动接受社会捐赠帮助河南筹集捐款用于防洪救灾工作，这是目前上海官方捐赠的正规渠道通过这个渠道呢是上海的慈善基金会为了 TEC 平台读者使用加注的双语通道那扫描二维码就可以捐赠了一起为河南加油另外三业交流会上这次会是您与有潜力的人才交流的好机会，我们诚邀各跨国及国内企业和机构在本次三一设立展位，如果你的公司有至少5个或以上的岗位空缺，或愿意提供活动赞助请扫描二维码立即报名因展位数量有限我们将会审核您的报名信息若您对展位要求有任何疑问，请发邮件至屏幕上显示的邮箱联系我们。那么随着这个备受期待的三一交流会的活动的临近我们呼吁更多志愿者来参与志愿成为活动负责人创业大赛导师或者更多的志愿者角色来帮助他人欢迎想要提供帮助的志愿者们通过屏幕显示的邮箱来询问和联系 Bristol 获取更多的信息。最后 ICS 非常感谢您对教会一直以来的支持及奉献你们慷慨的奉献对教会带来无私的改变，不只是教会的运营，而使蒙福的你我可以为社群和列国带来更大的祝福请注意有以下的重要通知， ICS 将停止接收通过联名银行账户和微信支付账户转账的奉献你可以继续通过我们的这个支付宝账户给教会奉献所以你可以扫描这个屏幕上的二维码，那么支付宝汇款备注里面呢 您可以将其留空啊。非常感谢大家的支持。如果你想通过银行转账的方式给教会奉献的话，请联系 ICS 的财务部获取银行账户信息。联系方式请见屏幕上显示的这个邮箱。你有任何问题，请随时与 ICS 的财务部联系，通过屏幕上显示的邮箱来询问。好的，在我们开始敬拜前，我们来一起做一个祷告。阿爸天父，我们在此为何牧师的线上正道代祷，求主在主日的线上讲道和敬拜中都与我们同在。在此我们为所有的线上会友祷告，让我们预备好我们的心，来到主的面前，全心全意的来敬拜我们的神和领受上帝要对我们说的话语。感谢主，以上的祷告奉主的圣名， Amen。 最后祝大家主日蒙福，并同心合一来敬拜我们的主，期待下次再与大家相见。
4, 3, 2, 1。We worship the God who evermore will be. He opened the prison doors, He parted the raging sea. My God, He holds the victory. There's joy in the house of the Lord. There's joy in the house of the Lord today. We won't be quiet. Shout out your praise. There's joy in the house of the Lord.Our God is surely in this place. We won't be quiet. Shout out your praise. Shout out your praise. Let's do now. We sing to the God of youth. We sing to the God of saints. We sing to the God who always makes a way.'Cause He hung upon that cross, then He rose up from that grave. My God, still rolling stones away. There's joy in the house of the Lord. There's joy in the house of the Lord today. We won't be quiet. Shout out your praise. There's joy in the house of the Lord. Our God is surely in this place. We won't be quiet.Shout out your praise. We were the beggars, now we're royalty. We were the prisoners, now we're running free. We are forgiven, accepted, redeemed by His grace. Let the house of the Lord sing praise. We were the beggarsShout out your praise. Hallelujah.桌前，献上我的敬拜，高举双手，扬声敬拜，救恩归于宝座上的神。在你宝座前，天使匍匐敬拜，万国万邦在天上说，救恩归于宝座上的神。上一生在你宝座前，天使匍匐敬拜，万国万邦在天上说，救恩归于宝座上一生。圣洁和公义。 天使告诉你颂扬，万物都继续来敬拜你，何等奇妙，何等
name above
above every name, fills me. All my days I've been held in your hand. The moment that I wake up till I lay my head, I will sing of the goodness of God. All my life you have been faithful, and all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God. Your voice, you have led me through the fire. In darkest night, you are close like no other. Known you as a father, known you as a friend. I have been in the goodness of God. All my life you have been faithful. All my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God. All my life you have been so, so good.
Father, we give you praise and thanks that we can gather online to worship you in spirit and in truth. We'd like to take this opportunity to pray for the recent COVID variant outbreak in Nanjing and different parts of China. We pray that, Father, you will help the authorities to quickly flatten the curves so that normalcy will return to all the different cities in China. We also like to pray for the outbreak in Australia, in Japan, in Vietnam, and other cities and countries, Father. We also pray for the different authorities to have the wisdom to know how to come up with an exit plan so that, Father, we will learn how to live with the COVID situation in order for the country not to be affected economically and to ensure that every one of us will have some normalcy in life. We give you praise and thanks that we can continue to worship you with our tithes and our offering. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Hi, I'd like to record this pre-sermon video so that it will help you to understand what I'm talking about in the entire sermon. We are covering on the topic on building a strong foundation. Jesus said that we should lay a strong foundation for the house so that when the stream comes and beat vehemently on it, it will not collapse. And that's what a wise Christian should do. We don't have a house, but what we have is a tumbler or bouncer where this is the base, it's firm, it's filled with water that gives the firmness to this whole tumbler. And when Jesus said when the stream beats against the house vehemently, it's like being giving punches to this bouncer. And sometimes when we receive bad reports of afflictions, tribulation, adversities, and different challenges that comes into our lives, those reports are like comes in our life that beats us, beat against the house, beats against our conviction. If there's no foundation, if we have never built a foundation on God's word, it will collapse. Just like what Jesus said, I mean, the foolish one with no foundation, when the first blow comes against the house, this entire structure will collapse. What hold this tumbler or bouncer firmly on the ground is this base that's filled with water. This is filled with air. So I want you to remember this illustration that when I talk about adversity, afflictions, tribulation, and challenges that comes into our lives that beats against us, the important thing to do is to lay that foundation. And that's the word of God. Amen. So what helps us to bounce back whenever we are hit is that foundation and our faith. When our faith speak out of our conviction, we will begin to be resilient. Resilience is the ability to bounce back from a situation when we are hard hit by it. So whenever we are hearing bad news, what helps us to be resilient in coming back to an upright position is the word, is our faith, is our conviction that we have built theologically. I hope you'll be blessed by the teaching today. Most, if not all of us, should be able to identify with the experience of being hit by different difficult circumstances that either broke us or pushed us to the limit.
我们大多数人，如果不是所有的人，都应该有过这种被不同的困难打击的经历，或者把我们击垮，或者把我们逼到极限。It
is not a pleasant experience.
这是一个非常不好的经历.
We might not be able to prevent such adversity, affliction, and tribulations, but we can definitely ensure that we can bounce back to stay resilient by building the right foundation.
我们虽然无法避免这些困境或者是苦难患难的发生，但是我们建立一个正确的根基，能够确保我们恢复过来，能够保证有一个反弹的能力。I
want to help you to build that foundation as an individual or as a family so that we can be people of resilience.
我想帮助你们能够作为个人或者作为一个家庭建立这样根基，成为有韧性的人。Turn
with me to Luke chapter 6 verse 46 to 49.
让我们一起看一下路加福音的6章46到49节。
But why do you call me Lord, Lord, and not do the things which I say? Whoever comes to me and hears my saying and does them, I will show you whom he is like. He's like a man building a house who dug deep and laid the foundation on the rock. And when the flood arose, the stream beat vehemently against that house and could not shake it, for it was founded on the rock. But he who heard and did nothing, it's like a man who built a house on the earth without a foundation, against which the stream beat vehemently, and immediately it fell, and the ruin of that house was great.
你们为何称呼我主啊，主啊？ 却不遵行我的话，凡到我这里来的，听见我的话就去行的，我要指示你们向他，向他，他向谁？他像是建造房屋的人，很深的挖地基，把根基建在磐石上。当发大水的时候，水冲击那房子，房子总不动摇它，因为它的根基建立在磐石上。若那听了见却不行的人，就好像是人在地上建造了房屋，没有根基，以至于水一冲来，它就立刻倒塌了，那房子坏得很严重。
We are familiar with the havoc that a typhoon or storm can bring to a village, town or city based on a personal experience or the news that we have heard or read recently.
我们可能很熟悉台风或暴风雨给村庄城市带来的破坏，大家或者是亲身经历，或者是最近在新闻中听到的。
Most of us were not adversely affected by the recent typhoon, but we are not exempted by the unexpected storms that leads to flood that beat vehemently in our lives.
虽然我们中间大多数人没有受到最近台风的不利影响，但是我们不能够去免于在生命的风暴中有洪水的打击。
Jesus is using his word to prepare us against these storms in life.
耶稣是用他的话语来预备我们面对生命中的这些风暴。
Jesus wants us to be resilient in the midst of the perfect storm in life.
耶稣希望通过这样的教导，让我们能够面对生活中完美风暴，变得有韧性。
Jesus mentioned that there will be tribulation in this world, but he has overcome it.
耶稣提到这个世上是有苦难的，但他已经战胜了。
The best assurance is the presence of God when we are going through a terrible experience in life.
最好的保证就是当我们经历生命中可怕的经历时，有神与我们同在。
Resilience is the ability to bounce back from a terrible experience in life.
韧性是从生活的可怕经历中能够恢复过来的能力。
It is God's grace for us to be strong despite of the horrible experience that almost broke us.
这是一个上帝给我们的恩典，让我们能够坚强地面对可怕的几乎打垮我们的经历。
Jesus is asking us to dig deep into his word and lay the foundation well for our lives.
耶稣叫我们能够去真正的挖掘他的话语的力量，让我们在生命中打好一个基础。
It is the best and wisest investments when we lay a proper foundation for our lives using the word of God.
我们能够用上帝的话语在我们生命中打一个坚强的基础的时候，是我们最好的也是最明智的投资。
One of the most important foundation is the Lordship of Christ in our lives.
其中一个最重要的根基就是我们知道耶稣在我们生命中是掌权的。
We will consult him before making any major decisions when Jesus is the Lord of our lives.
我们知道耶稣做我们生命的主的时候，在做任何重大决定前都要先请教他。
We will not have a firm footing or foundation when we are faced with an adversity, affliction, and tribulation.
我们面对的逆境、苦难或者患难的时候，我们有时候可能不能站稳，没有立脚的根基。
We will not be able to stand firm, just like the house that collapsed without a foundation.
我们不能站稳，因为就像那个地基没有打好的房子能够倒塌下来。
We will stand firm on God's promises as we are convinced that we are walking in the will of God, has a personal rhema word from Him, and exercise our faith by refusing to be affected by the circumstances.
我们要坚守神给我们的应许。就是我们要深信我们在神的旨意中去行事，有时候我们会从他那得到一句属于我们个人的那个 Rhema word， 就是说听到一个神的提醒的时候，我们就不会被环境影响左右我们的信心。
Faith has the anchor in the word that God has spoken to us without being wavered by the information that comes through our senses.
信心是神对我们所说的话语的一个坚立的锚，它让我们不会因眼见，不会因感受而改变。
We are immovable despite of the beating that comes from the evil one in our lives.
尽管在生命中，在生活中，我们遇到恶者给我们的巨大的打击，我们不可动摇。
That's resilience.
这就是韧性。
We will bounce back despite of the beating.
我们会遭到打击，但是不管怎么样，我们有反弹的能力。
The Lordship of Christ in our lives.
基督在我们生命中的主权。
Verse 46 says,But why do you call me Lord, Lord, and not do the things which I say?
路加福音的六章四十六节说，你们为何称我为主啊，主啊，却不遵行我的话呢？
The unwillingness to submit to the Lordship of Christ is a common problem among Christians.
不愿意顺服耶稣基督做我们的主权，这是很多基督徒普遍存在的问题。
We are happy to receive a ticket to heaven when we acknowledge Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior.
我们很高兴去得到一个通往天国的一个门票，但是却因为我们觉得我们在面对我们的罪 来认罪时候，我们得到了救主。
But some are unwilling for him to tell us what to do with our lives.
但是我们中的一些人不愿意要让他告诉我们该做些什么。
The unwillingness to submit brings about a lot of issues and problems in our lives because we will reap what we have sown in the flesh.
不愿意顺服啊，可以造成我们生命中的很多问题，因为我们知道我们收获中顺着我们肉体所撒种的东西。
The flesh is the sum of appetites and desires that want to live independent from God.
这样的一种说法就是属肉体是欲望和渴望的一种加合，它是要我们独立于上帝之外的生活的方式。
In short, it is rebelling against God's kind of lifestyle, the need to walk in the calling of God and His will for our lives.
如果简单来说，就是一种反叛，是对上帝让我们的生活方式、对他的呼召和上帝在我们生命中的旨意的一种反叛。
We want the best of both worlds.
我们是希望在两个世界中都能得到两全其美。
We want to continue with to have our lifestyle and flirt with the world.
我们想继续我们的生活方式，去沉浸在这个世界上的方式。
We can be going to church religiously, but refuses to listen to the prompting of the Holy Spirit.And the clear teaching of the word over the pulpit until we come to a dead end in our business, the corporate life, and even our family or marriage.
我们有时可以是选择去向宗教性的 去教会，但去不顺服圣灵给我们的提醒或者讲道中所有的话语的指导，直到我们有一天，我们的生命、我们的生意和公司和生活，还有我们的家庭婚姻走进了死胡同。
Let's look at Galatians 2:20.
我们来看加拉太书。
I have been crucified with Christ. It is no longer I who live, but Christ lives in me. And the life which I now live in the flesh, I live by faith in the Son of God, who loved me and gave himself for me.
加拉太书二章二十节说，我已经与基督同钉十字架，现在活着的不再是我，乃是基督在我里面活着。而且我如今肉身活着，是因信神的儿子而活，他爱我，为我舍己。
We used to live our lives based on what we feel like doing, including what is trending in the world.
我们有时候是在那个生活是基于我们想要做的事情，好像这个世界流行什么，我们做什么。
We believe that we are not accountable to anyone.
我们认为我们不需要给任何人负责任。
That's lawlessness.
好像是一种无法无天的形式。
That's the old lifestyle based on the wants and desires of the old man.
这是一种基于我们的欲望和我们的要求的，基于我们的老我的要求的生活方式。
However, we are new creation when we are born again and has the nature of God in us.
然而我们是重生的，我们是新造的人，我们里面有着上帝的本性。
Jesus has purchased and redeemed us from sin by the shedding of his blood.
耶稣已经用他的宝血赎了我们的罪。
He is our Lord and Savior, therefore we consider ourselves dead to sin, the sinful lifestyle, and has chosen to live our life for Jesus Christ.
因为他是我们的救主，我们已经承认了我们的罪，对罪的方式和对我们的死亡已经都死掉，这样我们要选择为耶稣基督而活着。
Jesus is the new owner of our lives and has a big say.
基督是我们生命中的新的主人，他对我们的生命有巨大的权柄。
We are to submit to the lordship of Christ.
我们要顺服基督对我们的一个主权。
We should live out the purpose and calling he has for each one of us.
我们要活出他对我们每个人的目标和呼召。
Submission to the Lordship of Christ in every aspect of our lives can be a struggle for many people.
对许多人来说，我们在生活中的每一个方面都去顺服基督在做主权的这样的一种方式，是一种挣扎。
Our priorities will be very different in life once we are born again.
一旦我们重生，我们生活中的所有的优先序次序会要不同的选择。
Matthew 6:33 says, "But seek first the kingdom of God."And his righteousness and all these things shall be added to you.
马太福音六章三十三节说，只要先寻求神的国和他的义，一切都要加添给你们了。
The top priority will be God, his kingdom, his righteousness, our family, and the rest follows because we have eternity in perspective.
我们的优先次序的首位应该是上帝、他的国、他的义、我们的家庭。其他方面将随之而来，因为我们有一种永恒的观点。
A Christian should have an eternity in perspective because we are aware that life on earth is temporal.
一个基督徒应该有永生的概念，因为我们知道我们在这个世界上的生命都是短暂的。
We are sojourners and pilgrims on this earth.
我们在这个地球上是一个旅居者，是一个朝圣者。
We will not be bringing anything with us when we pass on to glory.
我们真的是像荣耀离开这个世界的时候，我们不能带走任何东西。
Unfortunately, we spend a lot of time to develop our identity in the business or corporate world in order to be successful and rich apart from God.
不幸的是，我们花了太多的时间想去发展我们在商业上、在企业中、在这个世界上的身份，以成功和财富为目标。而我们却远离了基督。
We want to prove it to the world, especially those who have belittled us, that we can strike it out on our own and do well.
我们要向这个世界证明，特别是向那些曾经小看了我们的人证明，我们要靠自己的力量来取得成功。
That's pride.
这是一种骄傲。
There is always a price for being affluent apart from God.
离开了上帝，去寻求这种财富，总是要付出代价的。
There are sorrows that come with success apart from God. Our health, family relationship,And our walk with God will not be among the top priorities in our pursuit of success.
这样一种选择离开上帝的成功会带来很多的伤痛。在我们追求成功的过程中，我们把我们的家庭、健康以及与神同行这些优先次序都放弃了。
All these people will suffer even though they should be the most precious people in our lives.
尽管啊，这些人都是我们生命中最宝贵的人，他们都会遭到这样的痛苦。
In our search for significance, our pride has or might have led us to venture into doing something that we are not gifted or are not called to do, therefore we are failing in the venture.
在我们寻找要显示自己的荣耀的时候，我们的骄傲可能让我们去冒险做一些没有天赋或者没有被呼召做的事情，我们在这种冒险中失败了。
Some of us thought that we can be an entrepreneur and do a better job than our previous bosses.
我们中间有些人觉得我们会比以前的老板更好，因为我们可以去做一个创业者。
We might find ourselves buried in financial woes if we are rash in making the decision to start investing on a business or businesses.
如果我们没有做好的话，我们会自己做决定去投资一项或多项的业务，而过于轻率，然后会发现我们自己陷于财务的困境中。
I'm sure you would have heard of such individuals who have carried out what they thought they are capable of doing and got themselves into heavy debt.
我相信我们中间有些人一定听到过这样的人，他们靠了自己的能力做一些事情，却使自己陷入了很大的困境中。
Not everyone has the gift of being an entrepreneur or the ability to pioneer.
不是每一个人都有做创业家的这样的天赋和开拓的能力。
The person has to have a big picture, a strategic mind, able to develop the business, has good emotional quotient, and a very deep pocket, especially in Shanghai and all the first-tier cities in China.
这个人必须有一个全局观，有战略性的思考，能够发展业务，了解市场，有很好的情商，而且有足够的财务的一个积蓄，特别是在上海和中国这样的一线城市。
There are many good ideas, but not all of them will succeed, especially if it does not have the blessing of God.
你可能有很多很多好的想法，但是不是所有的人都能成功，因为你没有得到上帝给你的祝福。
Something or someone precious will suffer, even if it were to succeed, and it could come with a very heavy price.
一些很宝贵的东西，即使你是成功了，也会遭到损害，因为你会付出更沉重的代价。
Some have used different means or even unethical ways to climb up the corporate ladder.
有些人可能选择用不同的手段，甚至是不道德的方式去爬上职场的阶梯。
These are the people who could not wait to be promoted or hold a title of significance in the corporate world.
这些人迫不及待地想在职场上或者是在商场上能够晋升，拥有一个重要的头衔。
Some of us have our identity so entrenched in the job that the rest of the roles that we play as a parent, a spouse, and a child of God are suffering.
我们中间这些有些人，他们在职场上要获得的认可的地位是看得非常重的，以至于忽略了我们作为父母、作为配偶、上帝的孩子这样的角色。
Pride will cause us to fall and depart from the Lord, even if we are successful in the business, made a lot of money, and climb up the corporate ladder without God.
如果是没有上帝。骄傲会让我们摔倒，即使是我们在事业上成功了，赚了很多钱，在公司上爬了很高的一个职位。
We will not always win in life without God.
我们在生活中永远不会去胜利的，如果离开了上帝。
There will be the unexpected turn of event when the economy makes a sudden turn.
比如说，如果是经济下滑，我们会遇到一些意想不到的事情。
Our investment takes a beating and the world around us crumble.
我们的投资遭受打击，整个的周遭的世界都崩溃了。
We might be made redundant due to the slowdown in the economy.
由于经济的放缓，我们可能被裁员。
Our health might cause us to take a break.
我们的健康出了问题，必须停下来。
We will struggle with our identity again when our business fails, being made redundant in the company, or major setback that comes into our lives.
当遇到这样的生意的失败、公司裁员，或者我们遇到了重大的挫折时候，我们对自己的身份又产生了质疑。
I want to remind all of us that the main passage for today warns us that the flood that comes will beat vehemently on both the houses, regardless whether it has a strong or no foundation.
我想提醒大家的是，今天的最主要的信息是，当洪水来临的时候，不管有没有根基，都会遇到这样猛烈的冲击这些房子。
The wise will build a strong foundation in the Lord by listening to Jesus, and the foolish will ignore the warning.
聪明的人会在主里面建立一个坚固的根基，听从基督耶稣的话语，而愚笨的人会忽略了这样的提醒。
The damage will be great when there's no foundation in our lives.
生命中没有根基时候所产生的损伤是非常巨大的。
Don't be foolish.
醒醒吧。
Be wise by heeding the advice of Jesus.
要听基督的劝导，做一个聪明的人。
Jesus asks us not to worry about life and all that we need because we are more precious than the sparrows and the lilies in the field.
耶稣曾说要我们不要对生命和一切不要忧虑，因为我们比那些麻雀和野地上的百合花更宝贵。
He asks us to seek first his kingdom and his righteousness, and all these things in life will be given to us because he is a good heavenly father.
他说我们要先求他的国和他的义，我们生命中的一切所需所要的他都会赐给我们，因为他就是一个好天父。
The good heavenly father is not against us being successful in business or being the top man in the corporate world.
我们的善良的天父他不会反对我们在商业上所取得的成功，他也不会反对我们从职场上成为顶尖的人物。
He just doesn't want money to be your God.
他就是不希望只是钱财成为你的神
和偶像。We have read about all the men and women of significance in the Old Testament.
我们在旧约中看到了许多重要的男人和女人。
All of them were raised up for a purpose in God's plan.
他们都是因着上帝的计划中的一个目标而被提升的。
Likewise, God will raise us up to be a person of significance in the corporate world and business world so that we will be the salt and light for him that we can be successful together with God.
Yeah, 同样的，神也会提升我们的，使我们在企业中，在商业世界中成为重要的人士，这样我们与他同行，能够做光做盐。
The question is, do we trust God?
问题是我们是否相信上帝。
All of those whom I have mentioned in the earlier part of this sermon are people who do not trust that God has a good plan for their lives. Therefore, they have decided to strike it out on their own without God.
所以我刚才前面讲到半部分所有这些人，他们是不相信神对他们生命中有一个美好的计划，他们决定在没有上帝的情况下要自己解决问题。
Do we trust that God has a good plan for our lives?
我们每个人对神有信心吗？他对我们的生命是有好的计划的。
If we do, we need to consecrate our lives and draw out from the depth of our hearts His calling for us.
如果我们是相信的话，我们就要从我们的生命中要分别为圣，以神为中心，从我们的内心深处去寻找神对我们的呼召。
We are to take time to seek His face during our closet time, read the Bible and journal.
我们要花时间去寻求他的面，要在密室的时间中要读圣经来做灵修。
The best idea is to do what the Lord has placed in our heart to be in the corporate world, or if we are gifted, has a talent, and are called into being an entrepreneur or businessman.
我们能够做的最好的就是按照上帝在我们心中所带领的去做职场工作，或者是按照他给我们的恩赐去做这样的创业者或商人。
Of course, I do not discount the fact that God might call us to do something that we have no experience in doing, but it has to be really the Lord's calling.
当然我也不否认神可能会呼召我们中间一些人做我们根本没有经验的事情，但是这必须是神真正的呼召。
He will confirm the calling by giving us a personal rhema word, a witness in our heart, godly counsel, and possibly dream and vision.
他会来确认这个呼召，他会通过我们个人能够听到的 rhema 的这样的话语，或者我们心中的一种确证，或者是近前人的忠告，通过异梦或异象来确认这些呼召。
Let me tell you, this is an important step in building a life of resilience by consecrating our lives to Him.
让我来告诉你们，这是一个非常重要的一步，就是通过分别为圣，以神为中心来建立一个有韧性的一个生命。
Build the foundation on the rock.
在岩石上建立一个根基。
Verse 48 says, He is like a man building a house who dug deep and laid the foundation on the rock.
48节说, 他要像盖房子的人挖得很深, 把根基建在岩石上。
We are in the month of August where it is the season where expatriate will begin to repatriate or even be offered to either stay or choose an internal posting to another part of the world within the same company.
现在我们处于是个八月, 那很多外籍人士开始遇到了一个返流的季节, 他们可能在公司要求他们或者留校, 或者是选择去其他的公司的其他的国家工作。
Some people might even be at the fork road where they are offered to leave the company with a severance package because the company is not doing well.
有些人可能是在一个十字路口上, 因为公司的经营状态不好, 他们可能会被给一个补偿金, 然后裁员。
You might be thinking and processing whether you should start your own business, be an entrepreneur, or look for another job. It's a major decision.
你有可能会在这个时候来选择要不要重新开始一个自己的生意, 成为一个创业家, 或者重新寻找一个另一份工作, 这是一个重大的决定。
Let me briefly revisit some basics.
让我来简单的来回顾一下基本点的信息。
We need to live a consecrated and sanctified life since we have acknowledged Jesus Christ is the Lord of our lives.
因为我们已经承认耶稣基督作为我们生命中的主, 我们就需要选择分别为圣和成圣的生活方式。
When he's the Lord of our lives, it means he's the master, director, and God.
我们把耶稣基督作为我们生命中的主宰, 意味着他是我们的主人, 是我们的指导和上帝。
We will consult him for wisdom and ask him to direct our steps, even though we do have some plans in our heart.
即使我们生命中, 我们心中有一些想法, 但是我们会寻找上帝给我们的智慧, 因为他要指引我们下一个脚步。
Prayerfully, those plans, ideas, strategies, and the decision we are about to make are a result of a prayerful life because consecration and prayer are linked.
虔诚地去祷告, 这些计划, 想法, 或者战, 或者策略, 我们下一步该做什么样决定, 因为如果没有这样分别为圣的祷告, 是不行的, 是连接在一起的。
We cannot live a life of consecration without prayer, and we cannot have a prayer life without consecration.
我们不可能没有祷告, 过分别为圣的生活, 我们也不可能没有分别为圣的生活而去只过祷告的生活。
The prayer of consecration will help us to know whether it is God's will.
分别为圣的祷告是帮助我们知道神的旨意。Jesus
set an example to show us how we should pray to be in God's will and have His leading in every major decision that we make in life.
耶稣为我们树立了一个很好的榜样，他能够告诉我们如何做祷告，因为只有在上帝的旨意中，我们才能做每一个重大的决定。When
Jesus prayed in the Garden of Gethsemane, He did not pray to receive anything from the Father, but about becoming the sin sacrifice for the world.
当耶稣在科西玛园祷告的时候, 他祈求的不是从上帝那儿得到什么, 而是祈求为世人的赎罪而作为一个挽回祭。
This is the only prayer in all of Jesus' prayers recorded when he mentioned, if it is your will.
这是耶稣所有的祷告文中提到的, 就是如果这是你的旨意的话。
Jesus was praying about the will of God for his life when he said, nevertheless, not my will, but as you will.
耶稣为他生命中祷告上帝的旨意是说, 你不要按照我的旨意, 而是按照你的旨意。
You would also have realized that Jesus has mentioned it in different passages of Scripture that he came to do the will of the Father.
你也会意识到耶稣在经文里不同的段落当中提到, 他来是为了遵循父的旨意, 他要遵循父, 所给他的旨意而行。
If Jesus does the will of the Father, then how much more we are to model after his life by living in full submission to the plan and purposes of the Heavenly Father.
如果耶稣是寻求上帝的旨意而行的话, 那么我们应该怎么样以他为我们生命中的榜样, 完全顺服天父给我们的计划和目的呢?
A prayer of consecration is a prayer seeking the will of God for our lives.
分别为圣的祷告是寻求神对我们生命旨意的祷告。
We are praying, if it is your will, because we do not know the will of God.
我们在祷告会说, 如果这是你的旨意, 因为我们不知道上帝给我们的旨意是什么。
We do not have an agenda, but we will lay it all before God and ask Him to direct our steps.
我们没有自己的一个目标, 我们就说, 我们把一切都交在上帝面前, 请你来带领我们的脚步。
We do not make the decision, then ask Him to bless it.
我们先不要做决定, 我们再去要他来祝福我们。
It can be a struggle for many Christians because it deals with the Lordship of Christ in our lives.
这对很多基督徒来讲是一种挣扎，因为他真正是要把基督作为我们生命中的主宰。
It has to do with laying down our rights to decide what we want to do.
这是关乎于我们是否能够放下自我，去决定下一步做什么。
It takes surrendering and submission to God.
这是需要我们向上帝来降卑，来顺服。
A consecrated life is a purposeful and intentional life to make our lives count for the Lord in a marketplace.
分别为圣的生活是一种有目标的、有定力的生活，让我们在职场上为了神的荣耀而活。
Is it a good idea or God's idea?
这到底是一个好的想法还是上帝的旨意呢？
He is the Lord of our lives.
这是他在我们生命中的
主宰。It is so important for us to pursue, articulate, plan, and execute God's idea and dream.
对我们来说，去追求、寻找和表达、执行上帝的旨意。这是非常重要的。
However, it is good to obtain God's endorsement before we rush out to execute the idea.
然而，如果我们匆忙地去执行一个想法的时候，是最好先得到上帝的认可。
Not every idea is God's idea, therefore it's important to consecrate our plan, idea, and dream to Him.
因为不是每一个想法都是上帝的旨意，所以我们必须把我们的计划、想法和梦想去献给上帝，这是非常重要的。
Get a confirmation through book, chapter, and verse, including a witness of the Holy Spirit with godly counsel.
通过圣经的书或章节或者经文，或者是我们有圣灵给我们的见证或者近前人的劝告，来得到一个确认。
If we are confident it is God's idea, which means God will fund it, provide resources, grant us men of peace to help us and bless it.
如果我们相信这是上帝的旨意，上帝一定会资助他，提供资源，甚至是有贵人来相助我们完成它。
We will stand firm after ensuring that God is in it and will be immovable in the face of adversity.
如果我们确保上帝是在其中的话，我们就会坚定的在那里，不管什么样的境遇，我们都不会被动摇。
We won't be discouraged, blame, or become bitter against God when we are experiencing a very difficult time while walking out His calling.
当我们真正是行出神给我们的呼召的时候，即使我们经历了非常艰难的一个困难，我们也不会气馁，不会责备，不会抱怨神。
Once God has given us the idea, we own the idea and will know how the final product will look like.
一旦是上帝给我们的想法，我们就会持守这个想法，并且知道最终的结果是什么样子。
We are impregnated with the vision.
因为我们会被它感染了。
We will speak about it in faith.
因为我们会在信心中去谈论它。
We will begin to plan, strategize, and implement it when the time is right.
我们就会不断地在时机成熟的时候开始计划策略，而且去实施。
Let me tell you, God has a unique plan for every one of us.
要我告诉你们，神对我每个人都是有一个独特的计划。
It is an exciting life.
这是一个非常令人兴奋的生命。
Let's look at Ephesians chapter 2 verse 10.
我们来看一下以弗所书二章十节。
It says here, for we are his workmanship created in Christ Jesus for good works, which God prepared beforehand that we should walk in them.
这里说，我们原是他的工作，在基督耶稣里造成的，为要我们行善，就是神所预备我们所行的。
The word workmanship means something that is composed or constructed, something that is made, that is, which is manufactured, a product, the thing made, a design produced by an artisan. It conveys the idea of something artfully created.
工作这里是指的一种精湛的工艺品，它指的是通过艺术家组成、构造、制造的产品，设计的一个产品，它表达了一种非常巧妙创造的概念。
God is the master craftsman.
上帝就是这样的一个工匠大师。
You are something spectacular that God has created.
你是上帝一个奇妙的创造。
There are tremendous amount of creativity, talent, and gift that comes from Him.
因为有他，所以我们都具有巨大的创造力、天赋和恩赐。
He has created every one of us with certain skills, abilities, and talents, including the spiritual gifts that He has allocated to us.
因为他创造了每个人，使我们每个人都有技能、能力和才能，包括分配我们所有的属灵的恩赐。
Each one of us is unique and beautifully made.
我们每个人都是独一无二的，
精
美制作的。
We are an original, therefore we will never find someone just like us. Even our twins is very different from us.
我们是这样的独一无二，我们永远找不到一个跟我们一模一样的人，即使是双胞胎的人也不一样。
What we need to do as an individual is to find out the calling that he has for our lives through the prayer of consecration.
作为我们个人，我们所需要做的就是通过一个分别为圣、以神为中心的祷告，来找出他对我们生命中的呼召。
Let me tell you, he has a blueprint for your life in heaven.
让我告诉你，每一个人在天国里，上帝都给了我们一个蓝图。
Jesus said, may your will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
是耶稣说要我们在地如在天。
God has a will for your life in heaven.
因为上帝在天上给我们每一个人都有一个设计。
You need to live out that plan on earth.
因为你在这个地上要活出天国的样子。
Amen.
Amen.
Nobody has the same family history, background, experience in life, education, spiritual gifts, personality, and calling as you.
没有人的家庭历史背景、生活经验、教育、属灵恩赐、个人呼召完全是一样的。
We are artfully created by God.
我们是上帝最奇妙的创造品。
We need to be contented and have a desire to live up that special calling that God has for us.
我们要知足，因为我们知道渴望活出上帝对我们每个人特别的呼召。
Don't envy or emulate someone whom you admire because it can be very tiring since we are made so differently.
不要去盲目的羡慕或模仿你所崇拜的偶像，这样会很累的，因为我们就是不一样的。
We are to walk in His calling, armed with the gifts, talents, experience,and calling that he has for our lives, especially after we are born again.
我们要带着我们的天赋、才能、经验和他对我们生命的呼召，去行出他给我们的呼召，特别是在我们重生以后。
Now, while I'm not a businessman or a corporate man, but I'd like you to know the way the Lord prepared us is similar, including how he will journey with us during difficult times.
虽然我不是一个商人或者在公司里工作的人，但是我想告诉你，上帝准备我们的方式是相似的，包括我们在度过困难的时候，他都与我们一起同行。
Let me share with you my personal calling and experience.
让我来跟大家分享一下我个人的使命和经历。
Let me declare what the Lord has done in my life.
让我来向你们宣告上帝在我生命中所做的事情。
Now, I will not be sharing it in English because it's very long and this is a bilingual sermon.It will be read out by Carol in Mandarin.
我来读一下何牧师的个人的呼召。我知道我没有被呼召去做商业或者职场人员。那时候我在16岁的时候就很清楚上帝是给我一个全职的呼召。16岁那年，当我去泰国北部宣教的时候，我获得了一个用中文讲道的机会。教会的长老看了我用中文讲道就觉得我在服完兵役以后就去学神学院，即使我知道我自己的呼召，但是我还是拒绝了，因为我觉得学习的津贴不够我养活我的父母。我25岁的时候开始了职场的工作，我当时完全忘记了我个人的呼召，直到我被派到英国参加一个技术提升的一个项目的时候，在一个短期的寒假的一个短宣会上，我到了瑞典的一个基督徒大会，神这时候提醒我作为一个全职传道人的呼召，神的呼召是说，你可以逃跑，但你无法逃避神。神的恩赐和呼召是不可以改变的，因为当我们被呼召的时候，我们不答应神，他是会非常痛苦的。我从英国回到了新加坡，就提了辞职，我与斗润一起就开始在瑞典去就读神学院。当我读完神学院以后，我希望能够全职的去传福音，因为我并不想一个牧养教会的牧师，我渴望的去传福音，看到更多的人回应福音的道理，而且能够见证更多神的奇迹。我要去第三世界国家或者那些没有听到我讲福音的地方传道。我觉得当牧师是一种负担，我觉得照顾每一个成员，聆听他们的问题，24小时的去被传呼到，是非常累的。我只想讲道，我只想以传道人的身份，这样可以让我更兴奋。我希望把我的爱和关怀的这种工作留给其他的牧师。可是事与愿违，神确实安排了我不能以宣教士的身份来周游世界。虽然我有去过新西兰、挪威、俄罗斯、圣彼得堡去布道的经历，但是我没有意识到，其实我是有能力为神开拓疆土。记住我说过的，我们每一个人独特的拥有不同的技巧、才能、属灵的恩赐都是神给的。我后来被安置在一个有这个一个教派里的教会里，去开拓一个40多人的华人的一个事工，其中有大部分都是老年人。我被赋予一个任务，就是带领这些教会开展社群外展的工作。 我们有一个家庭的服务中心、托儿院，还有课外的一个关怀中心。一开始呢，我不愿意做这些开拓工作，因为我对中文不是很熟悉，每次用中文讲到好像是到了另一个层次。然而我做了一个分别为圣、以神为中心的祷告之后，我顺服了主，我知道这是他对我的一个计划。我记得我讲到先是用英文讲章，然后再是用汉语拼音去标注这个圣经，然后再去在脑子里同步去做翻译。有时候我会出丑，但是有趣的时候，每周我们都会见到有人得救，而且会把这样的团契变成一个有活力的中文的一个礼拜堂。神是我一个很给我一个很好的团队和不同的事工来跟我一起来做这种服事的工作。当我在他的旨意中工作的时候，神会赐给我很多恩典。我在做社群的外展事工的时候，他成功的设立了免费的补习班，还有课外的关怀中心，社区和家庭服务中心的孩子们都一起被吸引过来。我在教会的成员的主动报名下去教贫穷的儿童英语和数学，这些孩子们就接受了主。随之以后，他们长大成为了青少年的事工，这些事工就开始发展起来。这些事工到今天依然存在。这呼召是在新加坡持续了6年以后，主才又把我派到了上海。是神呼召我们到上海的。对我们来说，来上海我们要必须寻求神的面。神非常清楚地对导瑞和我说话，你可以想象吗？我已经用中文讲到唱诗歌，甚至用中文做辅导了6年。当我在新加坡的时候，神甚至给我机会用一些有影响力的一个机会去用中文讲道。神真是开启了我的门，就没有人能关上。但突然之间我要用英文讲道，英文的语法和中文是不一样的。尽管如此，我还是顺从了神的计划，就来到了上海，开拓和发展这个国际教会，这样的这个顺求神的旨意。大部分的国际教会呢，都不是用新加坡人来做牧养的，但是神却令这件事情发生了。 ICS 从最初的12个人的小团队，当地政府在虹桥的一个国际团契开始允许我们在一个3星级的酒店开始聚会，而且呢，只能开放给有外国护照的人。神让不同的人都先后加入了我们，让我们拥有不同背景、恩赐和才能的人聚在一起。我们在2008年开始了聚会，我分享了非常简单又实用的信息。你能想象吗？我来向来自不同背景、民族和不同国家和不同教派的这个企业精英们来讲道。好像每天都像走钢丝一样，要保证我的讲道是平衡的，能够让这些在场人能够接受，而且是并被他们喜欢。神做了很多的工作，要让 ICS 成长和繁荣到今天。这是神呼召我和我的妻子斗润做的开拓的工作。所以我会是成为宣教士的，但是神却叫我说，不要按照我自己的旨意，而是按照神的旨意。因为他的旨意成全我在生命中，直到我走到世界上最后一日。这是一个最好的态度，是在没有神肯定的情况下不去做冒险的事情，而只有神祝福了这个计划。这是一个分别为圣的生命。看，我知道我的呼召并不是做一个蛮有恩赐的教师，或者是做神学院的讲师，尽管有很多人觉得这样的工作是非常令人敬重的。我们要么获得人的尊重，和要么呢是我们顺服神，但是我相信后者是更好的。我不会是在于我的恩赐和呼召上去挣扎，也没有因为那些拥有不同恩赐和呼召的人会感到不安或自卑。我最大的渴望就是渴望在神的旨意中和他的计划对我生命的目标中能够活出来，因为我受造是何等奇妙的，是神的工匠所造。活出分别为圣、以神为中心的一个生命，奇妙之处就在于我们要完全的顺服于神，用一种信心来做一个轻快的旅行，因为我完全的依靠了他。在与不同政府、教会和领袖合作的时候，我是依到神给我的最好的一个带领，还有资金的一个支持的施工。教会里没有纷争，我们在耶稣基督里有完全的安全感。我不想成为不是我自己的那个人，而是完全成为神特别创造呼召的那个人。 是神带领我的每一个脚步，让我寻求他的呼召。当我与神同轭的时候，我会觉得非常兴奋。当我开始行在神旨意中，对他更有信心的时候，他会让我的道路更通达。在过去的14年里面，尤其是这18个月，在疫情爆发以后，我们的事工面临很大的挑战。感谢主，但是我们行在他的护照中，他对我们帮助我们是更有韧性的。当我们面对这次疫情，尤其是现在这时候，我会告诉大家，在线上聚会非常有挑战，因为你是没有可能见到你的教会的会众。我自己是不习惯于这样子在面对镜头来讲道的，因为这不是我的一个方式，我不是一种属于像现在的抖音的这样的社交媒体年代的人。但是正是在这个讲道中，我会希望能看到更多的会众们的反应的时候，我只能现在面对的镜头就是凭着信心跟大家讲道。我必须学会在镜头面前与圣灵一起运行。如果是谈那个打击房子的洪水来讲，感谢主，他的恩典够用，因为在我软弱的时候，他就会刚强。我们面对了很多政府的要求，包括我们在线上讲到要设立密码，不能有线上的讲座，或者是不能有线下的小组，而且每日的灵修还要有保护的密码设置。我是答应了政府上面的所有的要求。谈谈这个洪水的打击，更复杂的就是现在我们没有现场的主日的聚会，每一个人在疫情期间选择了想听谁就听谁的道，实际上是像一个属灵的自助餐或者是一个大的免费餐一样，所以每个人都可以听到世界各地的牧师和传教士的讲道。想想看，有谁愿意听一个上海的国际教会没有名气的一个新加坡牧师的讲道呢？这又是一次打击。据报道，在海外的很多教会因为疫情到爆发已经的关闭，而且有人说教会改到了线上以后，出席的人会下降，导致整个财政收入下降了70%到85%，这是一个很大的打击。海外当地的很多教会都被关闭了，羊群分散，讲员不得不回到自己的祖国去做这样的一个事普通的工作，所以自从疫情爆发以后，这些打击非常的严重。在疫情爆发的时候，我们宣布我们的 ICS 没有恐慌，没有失措。我们在儿童教会的同工的帮助下，很快在微信上就发布了一个线上的儿童的教会，并且我们把所有的手工制品送到了所有的孩子的家。我们的音响和录像的主管提出要改一个临时的工作室，并把它发展成一个非常专业的工作室。我们的青年团契也恢复了线上的聚会，我们在周三和录制主日讲道，周四晚上有小组组长来参加会议，周六的上午会录制双语的讲道。每周的收视率达到1000人，儿童教会播放达到130到140人收看，青年团契也是非常健康的。最后一点我要说，我们这个教会不是一个以钱财讲道为目的的一个教会，但是主却让我们2020到2021年的预算有超过50万的预算。感谢主，荣耀归于主。虽然是有逆境、苦难还有患难，但是我们的永生神在帮助我们继续前进。这是我的故事，这是永生神的教会不顾一切挫折继续向前，因为我们的门是被神打开的，我们要坚固我们的根基，和大家一起努力。
That's my story.
这是我的故事。
What is your story?
你的故事是什么？
What is your calling?
你的呼召是什么？
Have you been doing what Jesus has asked you to do in your calling?
你是不是已经按照神给你的呼召去做了呢？
We need to live a purposeful and intentional life for the Lord.
我们要活出一个有目标、有神给的意向的生命。
He is the Lord of our lives, therefore we should seek Him regarding what He has in store for us.
他是我们生命的主，所以我们要寻求他，看他怎么预备我们每一步。
We cannot serve God and mammon at the same time because we will love one or the other.
我们不可能又侍奉神又侍奉马门，因为我们只能爱其中之一。
All of us wants to be successful.
我们所有的人都希望成功。
We want to do well in our career and business.
我们希望在事业上和生意上做得好。
We can either be successful God's way or the way of the world.
我们可以选择要用上帝的方式或世界的方式来取得成功。
Whoever we love will dictate our lives and our lifestyle. Therefore, the consecrated life is the most basic requirement for us.To have the ability to be resilient in the midst of adversity, affliction, and tribulation.
我们是爱怎么样的一个主宰，就会导致我们用什么样的生活方式。所以，只有我们选择分别为圣的生活，才能让我们在逆境中、在苦难、患难中能有韧性。这是最基本的一个要求。
We are able to stand firm when we are confident that we are walking in God's will.
我们确信我们能够行在神的旨意中，这样我们就站立得稳。
We know that there is nothing that we have reacted or sown in the flesh when we live a sanctified life.
我们要活出一个成圣的生活，我们知道我们不会回应那些属血气的一些事情。
Both the consecrated and sanctified life is a life of submission to the Lordship of Christ.
分别为圣和成圣的生活是一种顺服基督做我们生命中的主权的这样选择。
We will act and decide based on holiness, justice, righteousness, especially in the area of business and corporate dealings.
我们会在圣洁、公义和公正的基础上做出行事和做选择，特别是在处理商业和公司的事务中。
It is easier for us to be resilient when our conscience is clear and the devil has no hold over us.
当我们无愧的良心帮助我们的时候，这个魔鬼就不能控制我们。
All we need to do is to exercise our faith in God and be patient to ensure that we are resilient in the whole deliverance process.
我们所做的所有的事情就是要锻炼我们对神的信心，并且有耐心，以确保我们在整个过程中是有韧性的。
Let me share with you a testimony.
让我继续来分享另外一个见证。
It is a story that was shared over ICS pulpit a few years ago.
这是我在 ICS 讲坛上分享过的一个故事。
I had the opportunity to journey with this brother.
我在几年前跟这个弟兄一起同行陪伴。
He was made redundant and was struggling with mild depression.
他被解雇了，因为他那时候有一些抑郁的一个症状。
There was a job offer, but the package wasn't good because there was no provision for his children's education.
当时他得到了一个工作机会，但是待遇不是很好，因为没有提供孩子们的教育基金。
The position and the scope of work was much lower than his previous job.
这个职位和工作范围比他之前的工作要低得多。
It really doesn't look good for a man of his status and experience.
这真的是不会给他添任何光彩，无论是他的位置还是他的经验来讲。
It will not look good on his resume.
对他的简历来讲也不会有任何的好处。
The wonderful thing was he committed it to prayer regarding whether it was God's will for him to take the job.
非常奇妙的时候他就是做了这样的祷告，因为他要看是不是神让他接受这份工作。
He consecrated his plans to God.
他把他所有的计划都分别为圣给了神。
He felt that it was a provision from God despite of the poor terms and conditions.
他觉得这是神给的供应，虽然待遇不是很好。
He humbled himself and took up the job.
他就谦卑了，接受了这个工作。
Of course, it was a double blow in his life when he was made redundant, receiving a much lower paying job, and his identity took a hit.
当他被解雇，在获得这样一个无论是职位还是工资都降级的这样的一个新的工作的时候，其实是一个很大的打击。
Nevertheless, he submitted to God's plan, adjusted his attitude, and began to thank God for the job.
尽管如此，他是选择了顺服的神的计划，调整自己心态，而且非常感恩神所赐给的新的工作。
He worked well in the company and gave his best in the job.
他在公司里工作得非常出色，而且做了很多。
The bosses began to realize his contribution, his good attitude, and the added strength that he gave to the team.
他老板开始意识到他的贡献和良好的工作态度对团队添加的力量。
It took more than 18 months for him to be promoted, offered a package that included his children's education.
过了十八个月，他获得了晋升，较好的一个待遇，包括给孩子的教育资金。
He was resilient in the midst of the whole process, and God restored to him some of the privileges that came with the job.
在整个过程中，他很有韧性，神恢复了他在工作中的一些特权。
Let us look at the tumbler and bouncer closely.
让我们再来看一下这个拳击柱。
What enables the tumbler to bounce back is the firm foundation.
如果这个拳击柱不倒，是因为它有坚固的根基。
Likewise, the building did not collapse when the stream beat vehemently on it due to the strong foundation that was laid before the storm.
同样的，如果一个房子在受到洪水冲击的时候不会倒塌，是因为它有一个坚固的地基。
How do we bounce back when we are beaten repeatedly?
当我们被打击的时候，我们如何反弹回来
？Withstanding the beating of the stream.
我们要站立在一个很顽固的根基上。
Verse 48 says.
第四十八节说
，He is like a man building a house who dug deep and laid the foundation on the rock.And when the flood arose, the stream beat vehemently against that house and could not shake it, for it was founded on the rock.
它像是一个人盖房子，深深的挖地，把根基安在磐石上。当发大水的时候，水冲了那房子，房子总不能动摇，因为根基立在磐石上。
The rock is Jesus Christ, who is the Son of the Living God.
这磐石就是耶稣基督，永生神的儿子。
We should build our foundation on Jesus, His work of atonement and redemption.
我们要把我们的根基建在耶稣上，因为他是我们赎救、赎罪、救赎的工作上。
Let me just pause here for a while.
我这里要停一下。
There are some people out there.
我们是说有一些人。
Maybe you're in your late 30s, early 40s.
你可能现在是在30岁到40岁之间。
And you are looking for a new job.
你现在在找新的工作。
Maybe there are some job offers for you.
也许你现在有了一个新的工作机会
，But the terms and condition is not as rosy as before.
但是所给的条件不像是你以前得到的那么好的一个条件。
You are struggling with the offer.
你非常挣扎，要不要接受这个
？May I encourage you?
我现在要鼓励你
，To humble yourself.
要谦卑下来。
Seek the face of God.
要去寻找神的面。
Check with your own heart.
要真正的去聆听你的声音。
What are you looking for?
你在寻找什么样的
Is this a job that God is giving you?
这是不是上帝给你的工作
But you're struggling with your identity.
你可能会对自己的身份在挣扎
You are dealing with the pride in your life.
因为你自己有一种生命中的危机
But I'd like to encourage you.
但是我要鼓励你
If this job is from the Lord.
如果这是上帝给你的工作
Just do it.
就去选择做
You will experience him.
你因为会体会上帝与你同在
As Christians, we have different values in life.
作为基督徒，我们对生命中有不同的价值观。
We should have eternity in perspective.
因为我们要有一种永恒观。
What is there to lose? I mean, to have our family together with us, we experience peace, we have God, and so what if it's a lower paying job?
即使是一个不是很高的一个工资的工作，但是我们能失去什么呢？因为我们可以与家人在一起，我们一起可以与神在一起。
I'll just stop here.
我现在就停在这里。
If there are people out there,
如果我们中间有这样的人
，If you are really struggling,
如果你还有这样的挣扎
，Humble yourself.
要谦卑下来。
Seek the face of God.
要去寻找神的面。
If God speaks to you,
如果上帝跟你说话
，Or even if your faith level tells you that you cannot continue with the current situation.
如果你的信息提醒你不能够再持续现在这个样子
Just take the job.
就去接受这个工作
We will be walking out the lifestyle of faith supported by His grace once we have consecrated our lives to the Lord.
当我们要选择活出有神的恩典支撑的这样的信心生活我们就是把自己的生命分别为圣给主
These are the possible adversities, afflictions and tribulations that will come upon our lives will be in the area of the loss of a job, business failure and financial difficulties.
是当有失业、生意失败或者经济困难的时候，这些都是发生在我们生命中的逆境、困难和患难。
It doesn't mean that there will be no challenges even after we have consecrated our lives and walking in the perfect will of God.
不是说我们就不会遇到任何这样的困难，即使我们就是活出分别为圣，也还会遇到的。
The storm that led to the flood that beats vehemently on the house will come regardless whether the house has a foundation or without a foundation.
不管房子是否有根基，这样的强大的洪水都会非常猛烈的冲击。
The point is the one with the foundation did not collapse.
重点就是有根基的房子是不会倒塌的。
What really helped us to withstand the beating of the stream is the foundation.
真正能帮助我们抵御这个洪水冲击的是这个坚固的根基。
Allow me to come back to my testimony.
让我再回到我的见证中
Especially during this pandemic period
尤其是在疫情爆发的时
间 We have a staff that left the church office at the start of the pandemic
疫情开始的时候我们就一些重要部门的同工离开
It is very difficult to recruit staff for the church
你知道去重新的招募教会同工是非常非常困难的
It is like a beating in my life
这就好像是 这样的一个打击。
It is a setback to the ministry.
这是对整个事工的一个打击。
To make matter worse,
特别又严重的是
we had a very capable staff who passed on to glory last May.
我们有一个非常能干的同工上刚刚也是安息了主怀。
And it was a beating in my life.
这是我生命中的一个很大的打击。
Staff left the office.
重要的同工离开。
Staff went on to be with the Lord.
而我们的同工离开安息了主怀。
It was a beating.
这是一个很大对我的打击。
It was a discouragement.
这是对我的一个大的挫折。
But what helped me to bounce back?
但是什么能帮助我能够有一个反弹的能
力？Is that I know that I'm called to this church.
因为我知道这是神给我的呼召。
That God will provide the resources.
因为我知道上帝会提供给我所有
的资源。And God brought in staff from different places.
因为上帝会帮助不同的方面。
To join the church team.
让不同的人来加入这个教会。
Amen.
Amen.
You know, we were told to set up new password for online sermons and devotion without the ability to inform the church members.
我们被告知在线上讲道和每日灵修要去设立密码，而不能够通过正常途径来
教会。It was a beating in the ministry.
真的，这是一个非常非常困难的。
I mean, when we were told to set password, for our online sermons and our devotion, and having no ability to contact all the church members, they are spread across China, across Shanghai, and in different parts of the world. It is as good as shutting off the whole church altogether.
我们 告知在线上讲道或者每日灵修要设置密码，但是我们却无法来通知在世界各地的会友的时候，真的就像是教会被强制了关闭。
It was a pressure.
真是很大的压力。
It was a beating against the house.
这就像一个强大的洪水来冲击这个房子。
But praise be to God.
但是赞美主。
As we shared earlier.
像我刚才我们分享的。
You know, the viewership is still healthy.
我们现在所有的线上收看是非常的健康的。
Regardless whether it's for the adults, the children, and the youth,
不管是成人还是儿童还是青少年组都非常非常健康。
Glory be to God.
是我们要把荣耀归于神。
The church belongs to God.
因为这个教会是神的。
My question to you is,
我对大家的问题是
，Is your business? Does your business belong to God?
你的生意是不是也是属神的
？If your business belongs to God.
如果你的生意是属神的
，Be resilient，
你就有这样的韧性。
Trust him，
相信神。
Did you consecrate your life before taking up this job？
你有没有在接受这个工作之前与神做一个分别为圣的祷
告 ？If you have consecrated your plan to God，
如果你已经分别为圣，把这个工作交给了神
，If there's beating that comes，
即使这样的打击冲击了你
，Stay resilient。
你可以继续保持。
Because you have consecrated your life to God，
因为你已经分别为圣了。
Maybe you tell me。
如果你告诉我说
Oh, Pastor Daniel, I forgot to consecrate my plans to God regarding this job.
你可能说哎呀牧师在我最初接受这份工作的时候我可能忘记了分别为
圣祷告 It's all right. God is a gracious God.
还是没问题的因为上帝是非常恩典的
Go back to the drawing board.
你可以再继续再回到你的密室里
Seek the face of God.
去寻找神的面
Let him assure you.
我非常的确信
And then anchor your faith in what he tells you.
因为当你把神的话语来能够建立在根基上的时候
And stay resilient, amen?
你就可以保证这样的韧性
You know, everything、amen. was online for ICS
知道现在 ICS 每一个活动都是线上
And I think church members are already tired of all the Zoom online cell group meetings
我想现在有很多教会的成员对这样的一个、Zoom 的会议都已经非常疲倦了
It is a beating on the church
这是对我们教会的每一个、会员的一个、打击。
But praise be to God.
但是赞美主。
The cell group meetings are still very healthy.
我们所有的细胞小组的聚会都非常非常正常。
You know, ICS is known for people who serve in different ministries.
ICS 这个教会我们有很多不同的事工。
And we have not been meeting for more than 18 months.
我们在十八个月中都没有见。
So there's a beating on the house.
这就像是那个洪水打击这个。
You do not know who else will serve when we resume church.
因为你知道，等我们真的复会的时候，我们都不知道有谁会出现。
But praise be to God.
但是赞美主。
People have written in and they are still serving in hospitality, in worship, in kids' church, in the youth ministry, and God is faithful.
因为我们得到很多人回复，他们会继续在接待事工、在青少年事工、在敬拜事工中服务，真的是赞美主。
I do not know what kind of beating are you experiencing in your life.
虽然我今天不知道你遇到什么样的一个真实的打击
，But you can stay resilient because you have built the right foundation.
但是我相信，当你建立一个非常坚固的根基的时候，你可以有这种韧性。
It is our faith in the Lord that help us to fight against the work of the evil one who throws tribulation at us once we have settled in our heart that we are in His perfect will.
这是我们有坚固的信心以后，我们才能有信心，能够保持韧性，面对这种恶者的攻击和患难。
Faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen.
信心是所望之事的实底，是未见之事的确据。
I know that God has called ICS to exist in Shanghai.
我非常确信上帝让我们 ICS 在上海来服务。
So we are not moved by the circumstances.
所以我们不会为环境所影响。
We trust the Lord.
我们相信神。
It is important to grasp what faith is, especially when we are in the midst of the tribulation.When the tribulation and the circumstances are contrary to what we perceive to have received a personal word from God.
所以我们了解信心是非常重要，特别是当我们在患难中，当我们的境况环境与我们以前所领受的是相反的时候，我们要有这个确信。
That's why I've always been encouraging you to seek the face of God in order for you not to be moved by the circumstances.
这就是我非常强调我们每个人要寻求神给我们的旨意，就是面对不同的反应的时候，不同的境遇的时候，我们还有这种确信。
We cannot prevent the stream that comes to beat against the house.
我们虽然不能够制止这样的洪水打击房子，
But we can build the foundation.
我们可以建造根基。
We can build the foundation before the flood comes.
我们在洪水来临之前建立根基。
In conclusion,
我们来做一个总结。
You and I are uniquely made by God, who is the master craftsman.
你和我都是神独特的创造，神就是那工匠大师。
You have a wonderful calling from God.
你有从神而来的非常奇妙的呼召。
He has a good plan for your life.
他给你一个美好的一个旨意。
Stay resilient despite of the pressure that comes upon us while walking out God's calling in our lives.
即使是面对压力的时候，也要保持我们与神同行，因为我们要活出神给我们的呼召。
We will definitely witness the hand of God in our lives.
我们一定会看到见证神的手在动工。
Let's bow our head and pray.
让我们来一起低下头做个祷告。
If you are listening to this sermon,
如果你今天跟我们在一起听讲到
you're not a Christian,
你还不是基督徒的话
you have never accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior,
你还从来没有接受耶稣做你生命中的救主
and you'd like to make the decision today,
你今天愿意做这样的一个选择
will you say this prayer after me?
请你跟我一起来做这个祷告
say, Dear Heavenly Father,
亲爱的天父
Thank you for sending Jesus to die for me on the cross.
感谢你派耶稣在十字架上来做的一切。
Forgive me of my sin.
请饶恕我的罪。
Come into my heart today.
今天进到我的生命中。
Be my God and Savior.
成为我的主，成为我的救主。
In Jesus' name.
奉主耶稣基督的名。Amen.
If you have said that prayer,
如果你做了这个祷告
please write to me. My email address is written at the bottom of this page.
请你跟我用 email 联系。
I'd like to connect with you.
我希望能跟你连接。
Let us pray.
那我们一起来
Father, we give you praise and thanks that your word has gone forth, it shall not return void before you.
亲爱的父啊，我们感谢赞美你，你的话语一旦出去就不会回来。
I pray that every one of us will choose to lay the right foundation in our lives.
我要祷告，我们每一个人都会选择用你的话语建立一个坚固的根基。
We give you praise and thanks that you are the master craftsman and we are the product of your creation.
我们要给你所有的赞美和感谢，因为你是那个精美的创造的工匠大师。
You have a wonderful plan and purpose for each and every one of our lives.
对我们每个人，你都给予一个非常精美而且奇妙的一个目的和旨意。
Help us to walk out your calling for our lives.
帮助我们按照你的旨意能行出来。
It will help us to stay resilient in the midst of adversity, affliction, and tribulation.
帮助我们在面对困难、患难和苦难的时候，能够坚持这样的信任和这样的一个韧性。
Now may the love of the Father,
愿天父的爱
，the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ,
耶稣基督的恩惠
，and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit,
圣灵的感动和交通
，be with you,
与大家同在
，now and forevermore,
从现在直到永远。
Amen.
Amen.
Hi, Church. I'm Kathleen, and I love to thank all of you for your continuous support for ICS and connecting with us through our online services during this period. We hope you've enjoyed and were greatly blessed by our weekly messages. And if you do, do show us some love and support by clicking the like button, subscribe to our YouTube channel by hitting the subscribe button below, and be part of this family. Also, you may hit the notification bell to receive a weekly notification so you won't miss out on our brand new video, which we post every Sunday. If you are new to ICS and haven't already, please don't forget to check us out on our website, Facebook, and Instagram as we post new updates every week. God bless you.